you are here tonight. This is one of my favorite days of the whole year because I get to brag about how awesome these kids are. I will tell you tonight's a little bit longer than our regular concerts because it's not only a concert, it's also an awards assembly. We do it all at once. So I hope that you don't mind me taking time to brag about the kids and their accomplishments because they have done so much, and I really think that just is very important that we all recognize all of their hard work this year. If you can please rise for the national anthem, followed by the Harvey High School alma mater, we're going to get started tonight. Again, thank you for coming. A bunch of students go and helped out with that. I really appreciate it. We're going to show you and sing New York, New York as we show you a slideshow from our trip. Thank you. let you know, I'm not going to announce everybody's names, but I do want to give a chance to recognize each group of kids and how many years they've been in choir. So just by a show of hands, people that are first-year members, can you please raise your hand? Second-year member. Three-year member. Go along through the evening. At this time, prep choir is going to continue with their portion of the program.
Good evening. I am Michelle Kimbrough, and we are the prep choir. We have worked very hard this year on singing together as a choir and developing ensemble skills. We have continued to learn to read music, sing with proper technique, and have studied many different genres of music. Our first selection is Singer's Rising Song, composed by Greg Philbin. This song begins with a triumphant banjo, followed by an exhilarating mixed meter, leading into a slower, majestic, contrasting selection, before building into a majestic conclusion. Please enjoy Singer's Arising Song.
Singer's Arising Song. Tyrone Landers, and I'm a tenor in the prep choir. Our next selection is Te Deum by Ruth Morris Gray. This setting of traditional Latin text is pivoting and majestic. The text can be translated as follows. We praise thee, O God. We acknowledge thee to be Lord, everlasting Father, all the earth worships. To thee all have angels, the heavens and all the powers, to the cherubim and seraphim, proclaim without thee. Please enjoy Te Deum.
This original selection combines folk and gospel elements in a laid-back style. We hope you enjoy acting the River Jordan as much as we enjoyed learning.
River Jordan, helpful.
Our final selection is Red Wing, arranged by Matt Tyler. French was a 1996 Tony Award winner for Best Music. Has been a hit movie. Live production, Fox. French adapts the classic story of the opera, La Bohème, for East. Following songs of then the Met. French,
What's on Glory?
About you, life, love in another day. Soloists in our performance are Tyrone Landers, Jennifer Grenier, Amanda Montserrat, Seth Razzo. Hope you enjoy our performance of A Medley of Friends.
Oh!
minutes to tell you about some of the accomplishments of the prep choir this year. This class always has a big struggle because not only are there's a lot of beginners, we have the challenge of singing at 7:15 a.m. I don't know about you, but at 7:15 a.m., I'm barely a human. So singing is extra hard. We did a lot of things to try to combat that this year. We had coffee Fridays and all kinds of things to try to get us awake and get us going. So I'm very proud of them. They came a long way. This is the first time in many years that we were able to sing four-part harmony. Our men were small but mighty, so we did a good job with that. We had a little bit more challenging repertoire with this group this year. Probably the best prep choir that we've had in several years. I'm very proud of them. Can we give them another round of applause? Give some individual awards to people from this group. The first award is for 110% effort. It goes to a young lady who every single day smiles, comes in, tries her best, is sick, says, "I'm really sick today, I don't think I can sing." Yet I look up there in the top row and she's given her 110%. She's awesome, she's a leader, she does everything that could ever be asked of her. Megan Preston. Another 110% effort award. This goes to a young lady who I have to say, you know what? I appreciate your effort, all of your singing, but this is not a solo. She sings out, she tries to lead her group, and sometimes I'm like, it's Jenny and the altos. So I'm really glad that she tried so hard and had a nice solo today. Jennifer Binnick. I have a couple most improved awards. The first goes to a young man who was so happy to have more young men this year joining him in the group. His voice, I think, has finally settled into place where it might be for at least another year. And he's hitting all the notes and doing a good job and really enjoying himself. Was a great leader this year, too. Josue Serrano. Another most improved award goes to another young gentleman. You heard him tonight. I love this kid. He comes to class every day, smiles. If you ever heard him laugh, I don't know how you can't laugh with him because it's infectious. He tries so hard. He sings out. He's just a great kid. Tyrone Landers. And one last round for prep choir. Next to the stage, we will have the Harvey High School Honors Choir.
Is comprised of
musicians who are members of concert choir and desire to work on more music and literature that is even more challenging. We are required to learn much of the music on our own and meet after school with Kodak as a group. Our first selection is PAA, written by Andrew Lloyd Webber. PAA is part of Requiem, a Requiem Mass that Lloyd Webber wrote in memory of his father who died in 1920. It was a new venture for Lloyd Webber, composer of numerous musicals including Phantom of the Opera and Cat, creating a piece of serious classical music. The music makes it Lloyd Webber's melodic and pop-oriented style more complex and at times even austere forms. Enjoy PAA.
Bass in the Honors Choir. Our next song is a medley from West Side Story, arranged by Len Tommy. Songs included in this medley are Tonight, I Feel Pretty, Maria, America, One Hand, One Heart, and Somewhere. We have enjoyed working on this medley and look forward to the release of the new movie version of this beloved musical directed by Steven Spielberg and executive producer Rita Moreno, which will include a full cast of Latina and Latino actors. Please enjoy these classic Broadway songs from West Side Story.
If you just saw Samantha Dilling walk in, she normally is a part of that, but today, good news, she's also a part of East City, and I know, and you guys can take a seat, and was in a competition for her entrepreneurship in Cleveland and won the whole entire thing, and that was to compete nationally, so I can forgive her for being late and not awesome. You're gonna be late, you better win. And she did. If you noticed in the program, we left out two of the songs that the honors choir is going to sing. If you wish to hear them, you still do have a chance to do that. The last couple weeks, I've been very sick, so we missed a lot of extra practices and we just weren't quite ready, but next week, we are going to be performing at Lake Erie College along with Mr. Jones and the Wind Ensemble. At Morley Music Hall. Wonderful venue. All of it, you'll hear those songs you heard tonight, and it's gorgeous in there, and the other two. So you can join us next Thursday at 6 p.m. and hear the wonderful Wind Ensemble and the Honors Choir. At this moment, I wish to tell you about these seniors. And this is going to get a little crazy because let me tell you about how awesome these seniors are. There are 14 seniors. They have pushed each other, encouraged each other. There's very little hatred. There's moments of hate, but they're usually super nice and encouraging to each other. Even when they don't, any other year, they could be the star. But there's so much competition because they're all so good. They performed at LCMEA, MLK Day, Emancipation Day, Constitution Day, Cavs Games, New York City. We were called by Fox 8 to come and perform at MLK Day. We were called by Channel 19 to perform for President's Day. In fact, one of the producers came to the LCME event a couple years ago to watch her own child and invited our choir to come and sing on her channel. So that was pretty awesome. Out of the honors choir that you just saw, 7 of the 14 students are all seniors. So they are kind of carrying our program right now. Of the district choir events that we go to, they've gone 11 times and represented Harvey. 16 times they've represented Harvey at CBC, and 5 times they've sung at Severance Hall with the Cleveland Youth Orchestra Choir. One of them has been in 2 musicals, 3 of them have been in 3 musicals, 5 of them have been in 4 musicals, and 1 of them has been in 5 musicals. They have had 7 of the leads, 4 of the supporting roles. One has been in 4 plays, one has been in 3 plays, they've had 3 leads for that. They've won a Best Musical, a Best Actress, a Dazzle nominee, a Best Supporting Actor, a Best Supporting Actress. They are the drama department. We're gonna miss them. So I'm very proud of these seniors, they've done a great job. So I'm sorry if I'm gonna go on about a little of them because they're just awesome and you need to know all the things that they've done. First one, though, we have some people who just joined this year and I'm gonna still mention them. Zaria Davis. If you want to come forward. She's a super sweet girl. I wish she had been in choir all along. She's very talented. Came in and I said, why didn't you join choir? She said, people told me you were mean. You're not mean. I wish I would have been in there. I'm like, spread that word. So next year she's going to Lakeland Community College. Each student is getting, I had plaques. I helped my mom clean up her house a while ago, and I had plaques from high school, and I thought, what do you do with those? So we quit giving plaques several years ago. And I make kids scrapbooks of all of the things for all of the years, and I hope that's just a little more meaningful for years to come. So each senior will get a scrapbook and balloons to take home. The next senior is also a one-year senior. A very funny girl, respectful, does everything I ask. Wish that 7:15 wasn't so early for her, because I miss her a lot of days. Next year she will be joining the U.S. Navy, and I'm sure she'll be getting up earlier than that. Rosella Wallace. The next young gentleman is a 3-year member Really probably would have been a four-year member, but with Auburn schedules, it's sometimes challenging to work that out. But I'm glad that he got back in this year. He's super sweet, he's kind. One of the first times I met him, he said, my mom said she went to high school with you. I'm like, I didn't go to school around here. He goes, yeah, we're from Lordstown too. I'm like, yeah. So he went to Auburn for 3 years, and he also does anything I ask from him. He was in The Wizard of Oz, and he was in Shrek. Next year, he's going to further his education at Edinburgh University. Me K Hill, I call him D Hill. This young man, love him too, a three-year member, again, an Auburn student, so sometimes a little bit of a struggle. I've already told you about his infectious smile and laughter. I hope that he laughs tonight so you all hear him. He's awesome. He came out of his shell in the last couple years. Since I had him in junior high, he hardly talked, he hardly said anything. Now he's just, I can't get him to be quiet. Oh, Wizard of Oz, he was in that, he was in Shrek, he was in A Little Princess. He's going to go to Hocking College to study culinary arts. Yeah. Tyrone Landon. Oh, Tyrone. See, can you hear him laughing? He's awesome. And if you saw his pictures from prom, not only is his laugh great, his jacket, he looks great. Bright red jacket, he looks awesome. The next group of seniors are all four-year members. I've had all of them, just about all of them, since seventh grade. They're my first group that I went back to Heritage to have. And in seventh grade, I thought, well, this is not gonna be so bad. This is not what I remember junior high being like, because they were so exceptional in seventh grade. They were doing things in seventh grade that I haven't seen since then. The first senior is a super sweet girl. She's helpful. She does tasks everyone else would hate to do. She tries anything I ask her to do. She likes to be different. You saw her prom dress. It was a swimsuit from all of her swimming, synchronized swimming, and then she made it into a prom dress. Check that out online, because it's awesome. She could never do the musical because synchronized swimming always was at the same time, but she always came and supported her friends. She did the play while balancing everything else and being a field commander. She was in Christmas Spirit, The Odd Couple, 3 Japanese Ghost Stories, and Geezers, and twice she was the lead. Hopefully she can bring home a Rotary Award. Next Tuesday. She was in CBC Choir 2 years and the Cleveland Youth Orchestra Choir 1 year. She is going to go to Akron University, University of Akron to study nursing. Olivia Dickinson. Next one, young lady I just told you a little about, she's a already knew she was a winner. She's come into her own, from drama and FBLA, and has just shown tremendous growth since seventh grade. She has a sense of humor and is a little bit too much like me. Sometimes it's a little scary. She works really hard on her own. She was my aide for a while until she realized I wanted her to do stuff. And then she went to the guidance office. Now she was in Ragtime. She was in The Wizard of Oz, for which she won Best Supporting Actress. She was green for a couple weeks after that. She was in Shrek and she was a Little Princess. Somehow she always ends up as the villain. CBC Choir, she was in for 2 years. District 7, she was in for 2 years. And Cleveland Youth Orchestra Choir, she was in for 1 year. She's gonna go to Cleveland State University and major in marketing, and I'm sure is gonna be great with that too. Samantha Dillon. Young lady, sensitive, thoughtful, kind, always cares about other people. Some sometimes she'll come up to me and say, how are you doing, Miss Sodak? Are you all right? And it's odd for high school students. I don't think that they all, it's not that they don't think about other people, but it's just a little bit different. She always goes out of her way to care about everyone else. She handles her business, does everything she needs to do, doesn't worry about what other people say or do, doesn't get involved in drama. She was in ragtime, and she laughed about that because she was able to be an immigrant in the white gang and in the Harlem gang, because she goes, I can, with the right clothes, I can be anybody. Good for you. She was in Wizard of Oz, she was Fiona in Shrek. She was green as quick as anybody could believe, and she was best a supporting actress in Little Princess. She was in CBC choir for 3 years and district choir for 2 years. She's going to go to The Ohio State University and major in criminal justice and criminology. The next young man, super hard worker. I don't know if there is somebody that works nearly as hard as this young man does. He does whatever's asked of him. In fact, I don't even have to ask him, he just does it. He's learned all of the solos for several years in case people didn't learn them or they didn't show up. He has been super helpful with tasks that are just have to be done to make things run. And his voice has really matured over the years. Really, really very nice. He was in the Addams Family as an 8th grader and was in Ragtime as a 9th grader. Wizard of Oz, he portrayed the Lion and won Best Supporting Actor. Then he was Shrek, and he made the most of being green, ugly, and having to fart on demand. And then this year, he was the lead Captain Crew in Little Princess. So out of his 5 years of being in a musical, he was the lead 3 times. And it just has shown great dedication. He was in CBC choir for 2 years, district choir for 2 years, CYOC choir for 1 year. He's going to be going to Cleveland State on a full tuition scholarship in engineering. Scholarship. All these kids, they do all that stuff that I listed, plus other stuff. Like, I'm like looking at this going, that's a lot. But they do all kinds of other things on top of that. Next young lady is a sweet, quiet girl who came out of her shell. I don't know if in junior high I heard her talk, except for like when she had to sing. And now she was in my little trip, my little group of New York, and was I realized how funny she is, and just she has come out of her shell and blossomed. She's a great part singer and has been a solid member of the ensembles of Ragtime, Wizard of Oz, and Shrek. She was also in the CBC choir for 2 years. She's going to also attend Cleveland State, and she's majoring in speech and hearing. Anna Omachinsky. The next young lady, told you a little bit about, she's always smiling, she's a leader in prep choir, and super sweet. And what I like about her is, she doesn't have to be the star to still be happy. Because sometimes that's very difficult, and you need people like that. You know, a choir can't be a whole bunch of soloists. Sometimes you need people to just sing the parts. And she's fine with that, and does a great job with that, and I love that about her. She was a member of Ragtime. In Wizard of Oz, she was our little Toto whisperer. She took care of him and handled him because he was a little challenge. In Shrek, she was so proud of her big head costume. And if you saw her, you know what I'm talking about. And then in Little Princess, she was a great help with all the scene changes and all the backstage stuff. And she's just a wonderful young lady. She's going to continue her education at Lakeland Community College in the fall. Megan Preston. I think he became interested in all of this because his older cousins were involved. When he's interested in something, he really like looks into it. I like that. He's into musical theater a little bit, and it was odd because I really didn't know how much he was into it until he said, well, I heard about that, and then I looked it up, and I did this, and I'm like, good for you. So I love that he has the pursuit of knowledge without even being asked to do it. He's super proud of being what he calls the founding member of the Bass Boys. I don't know, they have little signs for that. If you see pictures and it looks like it's gang signs, no, it's just their bass boy choir signs. He's a member of Ragtime. He was a member of The Odd Couple. He was a member of Wizard of Oz, and he was a member of three Japanese ghost stories, Shrek, Geezers, and A Little Princess. So he did all of the musicals and three of the fall plays. I've never seen a kid love costumes so much. He asks Ms. Mockner all the time, can I take this home? Can I keep this? She's like, no, get that back, Carlos. But he loves his costume. He was in the CDC choir for 3 years, district choir for 3 years, and the CYOC choir for 1 year. He's also going to Cleveland State. He's going to major in mathematics and physics and with the hopes of becoming a teacher, and I think he would be a great teacher. Carlos Sandoval. The next young gentleman, I think, was a bass in seventh grade. I felt bad for him because all the other kids are singing soprano alto, and he's like, the solo come here. He's super polite, he's thoughtful, he's wonderful. He's my hookup for flowers, so if there's other Boy Scouts out there, I need flowers for next year, and I buy a lot, so see me. He managed going off to Auburn and still being in choir all 4 years, which meant he came in after school, learned a lot of stuff on his own, and did some things to make that happen. In Ragtime, he was the funny grandfather, and he was also in Adam's Family. Then, unfortunately for us, he decided to focus on wrestling, good for wrestling, and I think was great at that, too, probably. He worked extra hard, and I'm really proud of him. Alex Spondek. Okay, last one. But not least. The next young lady is super talented. She's willing to try to do anything I ask her, things outside of her box. She's grown into a spunky, funny, outspoken young lady. She has a great ear. She listens for problems, and she'll come to me and say, I think we're having struggles with this. We need some help with that. And it's just really good. While I'm trying to play piano and listen to all the things, it's nice to have somebody that can help with other things. She was in Ragtime and in her brother's shadow, but was helping lead that ensemble. In Wizard of Oz, as a 10th grader, she was Dorothy, and I thought, am I doing too much for a 10th grader? Because that's a big role. She had to work with a dog. I was throwing a bunch of other stuff at her, and she did a great job. In fact, she won the Rotary Award for Best Actress. Then, after that, I switched it up, and I said, let's see if she can be two parts. And in Shrek, she was Gingy and had to have a different voice than when she was Sugar Plum Fairy. Many kids would have been upset about having a lead role and then getting moved to a different role, but she handled that and in fact was a Dazzle nominee at Playhouse Square for that role. Then this year, if you came to see the musical, she was Sarah Crewe in A Little Princess and helped make that show a wonderful show. We still have our fingers crossed that we got some nominees for Rotaries next week. CBC Choir, she was in for 2 years. She was in District Choir for 2 years. She was in Cleveland Youth Orchestra Choir for 1 year. Next year, she is going to go to Ohio University to major in biology. Samantha Tackett. Tonight's the class of 2019. Thank you for listening all about them because I am so super proud of them. Without listening to me talk anymore, let's go on with the concert choir.
Isabel Dingle, a sophomore alto, and we are the concert choir. We have been working on a variety of styles of music this semester and are excited to share our hard work with you. Our first selection is Lamentations of Jeremiah, composed by Z. Randall Stroop. This expressive and dramatic work interprets the cries of the prophet with mournful chant and impassioned rhythmic fervor. This is currently on the large group contest list in many states. We hope you enjoy Lamentations of Jeremiah.
Selection is How Can I Cry, composed by Moira Smiley. We enjoyed the challenge of this moving a cappella arrangement. We have Anissa Hudson as our featured soloist and Tyree Rice accompanying us on percussion to this piece as much as we enjoyed working on it.
Was the 1987 Tony winning award musical and is currently the fifth longest running show on Broadway. The musical movie was recently released and it can still be seen across the country in many Broadway touring productions. Please enjoy Bring Him Home.
evening. I am Nicora Echo. Our next selection is Everywhere That You Are, arranged by Andy Beck. From the stage adaptation of Roald Dahl's James and the Giant Peach, this sensitive ballad tackles the tough topic of loss in a warm and reassuring way. Although this 2010 musical never became a hit on Broadway, it has found life in youth and regional theater production. We love working on the expression of the lyrics and hope that you are touched by them as well.
Your truth, that's the I saw in our portion of the program, the medley from Kinky Boots and the Rainbow Bag.
Step one, the history of wrong guys. Take what you got. Everybody say yeah. Hold me in your heart. Raise you up. Just be. Kinky Boots was the 2013 Tony Award winning music. The score written. Tony and Grammy Award winning Cindy. Our medley features several soloists. And we are accompanied on drums by Mr. John. We are excited to sing these songs after working with actors from the cast, seeing the live production on Broadway. We hope you enjoy our performance of this medley from Kinky Boots as much as we enjoy the Broadway.
Oh, God. front of me.
The best parts of me.
In front of you.
Standing in front of you. And loves you anyway.
She learned her part in like a week because we had some issues with people that were missing and we had to have a replacement. And she learned a whole entire part for a play in like 2 weeks. So she's been doing a great job for us. Most improved, Annika Engelhardt. Outstanding freshman. This kid does a lot of different things. Sings well. You saw Geezers. He was the greatest old man ever. Thank goodness you heard about all those seniors. Thank goodness I have a freshman like him that's coming up to take their place. Emmanuel Stewart. The outstanding sophomore. Lady who was always a good singer, but this year stepped it up to a whole nother level, took on challenges, asked how she could get better, stay after school, did some things to improve. Outstanding sophomore, Isabel Dingle. Outstanding junior. He and I kind of go at it at times because he likes to go, so, and then I go, Malik. And then he does whatever he needs to do because he's awesome. Tries his best every day and is a leader of the bass section, Malik Walker. I have two other special awards. These two awards go to our honorary choir members. These two students are not in choir, but for the past 4 years have showed up to all of our concerts, helped out, done things, played drums, played percussion, did lights, did sound, have just been a great part of the choir, even though they're not in it. Samaje Jordan and Francisco Valdivia. What those kind of people do. You know what? They don't get any kind of glory. They just come here, they make everybody else look good, and every day go home, pack it up, and go, how else can I help? I love them. Next award. You heard about all those seniors? Unfortunately, we only have 2 national awards, so I'm giving out a couple extra different awards, because any other year, several of those seniors could have won some of the big national awards. I'm going to give a director's award to 2 young ladies who helped me in all kinds of different ways. You heard all about how wonderful they were earlier. Director's Awards this year go to Olivia Dickinson and Samantha Doeing. Of our community. Last year we started sending kids to Broadway camp at Playhouse Square. This year I had enough money to send 6 students to Broadway camp. Our scholarship winners to go to camp for free this summer are Cecilia Cervantes, Isabel Dingle, Landon Jenkins, Marcus Mendez Gibson, Lizette Rosso, and Emmanuel Stewart. The seniors with the senior song and then our closing number.
I can almost see it, that dream I'm dreaming, but there's a voice inside my head saying, you'll never reach it. Every step I'm taking,
every move I make feels lost with no direction.
My faith is shaking,
but I gotta keep trying, gotta keep my head held high.
me down, but no, I'm not breaking. I may not know it, but these are the moments that I'm gonna remember most, yeah. Just gotta keep going, and
I got to be strong. Just keep pushing on. So it's gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes I'm gonna have to lose. Ain't about how fast I get there. Ain't about what's waiting on the other side. Here's the
night, and then we'll conclude with our final number. The last two awards are national awards. The first of the two national awards is the Marian Anderson Award. If you don't know about Marian Anderson, she was an African-American singer who was a trailblazer. Ended up singing, was not allowed to sing at some places, ended up singing at the mall in Washington, D.C. to the largest crowd in history at the time. Did a lot of different things for civil rights. If you don't know about her, look her up. Just an amazing woman. This award goes to another amazing woman who I know can also be a trailblazer, Recora Eccles. The last two awards are, I'm giving two. It's the National Choir Award. I could not decide on one student, so I ordered two. The National Choir Award this year goes to Samantha Tackett and Billy Kalina. Can I please have their mothers come up and sing them? This is Kalina and this is Tackett. These major winners also get their names engraved on plaques that will be out in the lobby if you wish to look at them. They get little trophies forever, and whichever gets in, their parents can put a pin on them, because this will be forever in Harvey history. And as everybody knows, behind great kids are great parents. These two ladies, because of their kids, I've gotten to know them, and they have been a great help all along, and I'm so proud of them for helping me and helping their kids and raising wonderful young ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, parents. We're going to conclude tonight's performance with a song from Fame called Bring On Tomorrow. much.